Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Eid Mubarak. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. If this is the first video you're watching on my channel, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. And if you're new here, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button down below and join the Sarah squad. And also click on the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. Video, we are not really discussing any beauty or lifestyle content here. If you're an OG and if you've been watching my videos for a while, you know that there is a difference in the setup we have going on. My face looks brighter. I'm hoping that the light is set up properly and my videos are not being shot in natural lighting anymore. And as you can probably tell from the title of the video, this is all courtesy of YouTube India. This is all courtesy of YouTube Next Up. So in this video, I'm going to take you through my journey at YouTube Next Up, how I got here and why YouTube ended up giving me equipment worth 1,40,000. So if you're interested, then please keep on watching. So if you're new to my channel, you probably don't know this, but I'm also a final year occupational therapy student. I'm a medical student and I came onto YouTube purely out of passion. I never really saw this getting this big in the future. I just kept creating content, and now that I look back over the past 3 years, I've created over 120 videos, more than that actually, and that's insane to me because I never really anticipated doing so much work. I just kept on creating content because I genuinely enjoyed it so much. I didn't really see this going anywhere. I didn't really see myself going anywhere with YouTube. But with YouTube Next Up, my entire perspective towards YouTube, towards the way I look at my platform now, and towards the way I work towards my platform now, everything has just changed. So basically, YouTube Next Up is a competition. It's probably the only competition that is held from the YouTube space itself. It all started about February, if I'm not wrong, where we all got emails. All the beauty creators, I'm guessing, on YouTube got emails and there was a Google form attached to it that said that if we are interested to apply for YouTube Next Up, then we're supposed to fill out the Google form, and thereon they would take the process ahead. So it's basically like just submitting your entries. Now, filling that form, I didn't really know what YouTube Next Up was, because I saw the official YouTube logo and I saw that it was also in collaboration with L'Oreal Paris. I completely just went ahead and filled out the form. It was a long and tedious form. It asked a lot of questions about what I envision my channel to be, why am I on YouTube, and what my channel is all about. So there was a lot regarding my channel and also about me that I had to fill out in the entire form. And I did it personally just because I thought it's like a survey, because we do get a lot of YouTube creator emails monthly that talk about how our channel is doing monthly, but it's never really about an interview. So I just thought it's sort of a review about YouTube or something like that on those lines, and I just filled it out and I sent it. After that, there were follow-up emails that kept happening and that kept saying that you are one of the shortlisted winners, you are one of this. But it was always all confidential information and I was not really supposed to reveal it. And I didn't really know what it was, and I don't know why I never really bothered Googling it. Every time I saw that email, I would just like be like, okay, fine. Till I know what this really is, I will not really take the effort to tell anybody. So I did not tell this to anyone. None of my friends knew. Nobody actually knew that I had applied for this. And I did not know what I had applied myself into. So then the final email came in somewhere, I think about April, when we finally came to know that I was one of the 12 winners for YouTube Next Up. And we got an official email from L'Oreal also that said, you are chosen because you are worth it. And that is where I was like, dude, this is big. I don't know what this is, but this is big. And I remember emailing back to the YouTube Next Up coordinators asking that, what is this exactly? You know, what am I signed up for? And she was like, you will come to know in further on from now, you will come to know what this is about. And so there began our journey with YouTube Next Up. And that is when I then finally told my best friend, and then she took the effort to Google and find out what YouTube Next Up was and tell me that it's actually a 5-day creator camp that happens at YouTube space. And they teach you a lot about how to grow your YouTube channel organically, everything about engagement and analytics and editing and filming and stuff like that. And along with all the other multiple perks that come with being a YouTube Next Up winner, you also get a 1,40,000 worth of grant, which allows you to purchase production equipment. So basically a camera or a lens or lights or everything that goes into filming, basically a production equipment kit. So along with me, there are also 11 other amazing creators from the beauty space of YouTube, and I'm going to leave all of their links in the description section. So you should go check all of their channels out. Go subscribe to everyone, because all of them are super, super amazing. Honestly, being very, very honest here, initially when I was even selected as a winner of YouTube Next Up, I was feeling so, like I don't belong here. Like, all these 11 other creators are so amazing, so good at what they do, and I genuinely felt that I don't fit in here. But all of them are so, so sweet that I wish I could meet all of them in person. The entire YouTube Next Up team is so great. They are so full of energy. Every session I feel like I belong here. I feel like, you know, YouTube cares about me just the way I care about my channel. It's not just about me being on the platform, it's also them noticing us, it's also them witnessing our work and wanting us to do better. That is the ultimate. If you've observed over the past couple of months, I've been creating more content. I've been creating more specific, dedicated content to what my audience enjoys watching. I've also changed the way I do my thumbnails. I've been trying to tweak around the way I do my videos. I'm playing around with my setup. I'm playing around with so much, and I'm really experimenting because now I'm genuinely enjoying the technicalities of this, which I never really did, because there's somebody to teach me, there's somebody to guide me. There was really no one to guide me. When I started, I did not even know how to edit videos. I don't know why I thought that I could do this, because I did not even know. I didn't even have a proper laptop, okay? I was using this old laptop that used to take me so much time to edit videos. For almost a year, I was using that laptop, and so many times that I was editing videos, my thing would just crash. And then I would lose all the editing, or I would lose all the data. I did not have storage space to keep data that I was filming. I have struggled so much one entire year of doing YouTube. I didn't even have my own camera. And then I finally went ahead and invested in a camera for myself. Jiska EMI I was literally still paying till like January 2020. So that is why when we were asked to choose what production equipment we wanted, I didn't surely choose a camera. All the other creators did choose cameras and lenses. I don't use a camera that requires lenses. It's a vlogging camera. I could get a mic because my audio is definitely an issue. But again, my camera does not have a mic input. But my major issue was also my editing. For the first year, I did edit on a very old school laptop, but then later on I did upgrade to the MacBook Air. And even though MacBook Air is amazing and processes really fast, it's still not fast enough. There were very many times that my laptop used to crash and used to not be able to process the data I did actually put into it. So because of that, I chose to upgrade, and my major upgrade with this budget is the MacBook Pro. I finally got the pro level laptop that all the creators use, and getting a MacBook was the practical option for me because I do have all the other iOS devices, so I can't really choose a regular Windows laptop, and MacBook Pro has a much faster processor. This is a quad-core processor with i5 and 1.3 gigahertz, I want to say. All of these are words I did not even know what they meant before. I was given a huge list of equipment to choose from, and I had to sit and Google everything, see reviews for everything, and find out what would be the best thing for me to get. So I'm going to open this bad boy. Oh my god, this is such a classy laptop, you guys. I do have the MacBook Air, and in comparison, honestly, of course, this is twice the money, but it's also so much more compact. It's a 13 inch size, and I chose the color space gray because I've already used a silver MacBook, and yeah. So this is what I spent my major grant money on, because since I already had a camera, it was wise for me to get a laptop at this point. Getting a better laptop would mean that I could edit faster. I also have better storage in this because this is the 256GB, whereas my MacBook Air is the 128GB. I'm also going to be upgrading my editing software from Final Cut Pro to Adobe Premiere Pro. So I'm waiting to get my hands on the Adobe Premiere Pro so that I can start using this bad boy. For now, this is just going in the box back again, and I'm not really using it till I get the software. And so, having spent most of my money on that, since I did talk about space issue, I had to get a hard drive for myself. It's a very smart option to get a hard drive to be able to edit through that and to be able to store all my data in that. So that's why I got the Seagate hard drive backup plus hub. So this has all of the adapter and everything. So this is what it looks like. It's one of those big bulky hard drives. It's 4 TB, so it's gonna store a lot of my data. So all my data storage issues are hopefully gonna be taken care of. And then the third and final thing that I could squeeze into my budget was very, very important to me. You know how much I crave about shooting in natural light, because in a place like Bombay where it keeps on raining and the skies turn gloomy and sunny here and there, it's very difficult for me to adjust natural lighting. And so I finally got a proper Godox LED light, which I'm currently using. So I'm gonna insert a clip right here of what exactly my setup is looking right now. So this is the Godox SL60W. It's a professional studio light. It is very, very out there and bright, and it also has adjustments. I really genuinely, you guys, if you all are watching this, if you all have a passion, if you all are passionate about something, 100,000 people are gonna tell you, don't do it, you can't do it, you can't do it with your medical college life. It's very difficult to balance YouTube and studies. You're not gonna be able to do it. There will be 1,000 voices telling you why you should not be doing it. But if there's just one voice telling you that you should do it, do it, do it, and you will see the results. Alhamdulillah, I'm very, very grateful for everything. I know you might watch this and be like, wow, she got a MacBook for free, because I did get a lot of DMs on Instagram when I put up the photo that, did YouTube really give this to you for free? And how do I explain this to you in normal terms? You know how you're a good student and you get a scholarship so that you get into better tuition? So this is like when you're a good YouTuber, you get a grant so that you can become a better YouTuber. So I know everybody just sees the price and nobody really sees the struggles behind it. But my OG subscribers would know from where I've come, and I've come a long way, you guys. And I'm very grateful to all of you who've subscribed, to all of you who watch my videos, to all of my friends and family who've, like, you know, supported me so much over the years. I'm so emotional right now because they were the people who told me I could still do this. Even on my hardest days when I felt like I could not do this and I wanted to give up completely, they didn't let me give up. You know who you are. So I love you all so, so much. Thank you for being there for me. Thank you for being my spine. Thank you for being my Sarah squad. I love you guys so, so, so much. This is all I had to share for today's video. Hopefully I get better and better from here, inshallah, and can upgrade to a better camera one day and finally get a mic one day so you don't have audio issues. If you really want me to get a mic, stop skipping my ads. Today's video, Sarah Squad shout out goes to Harshita Raj. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video, Sarah Squad shout out, then all you have to do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sarah Squad, and you'll get a chance to be a part of next video, Sarah Squad shout out. If you did actually like this video, don't forget to hit the like button, and I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you all.